check out our website, bcimprov.com, to check on that. Classes are going to be starting again in July, so you have some time to think about it, check out some more shows, see what it's like. We actually have student shows here this weekend, if you really want to see.
Never gonna have a laugh, we'll sit back, don't you doubt. to tell you the mama story?
Forgiving trauma over and over. Go ahead.
Well, it's gonna require another pull of my mint julep.
You're always drinking your mint juleps, Daddy.
Yes. Ever since your mother died, I got hooked on the mint juleps. God knows it's what took the woman. And I hope one day it might take me to home to a place where she used to be. That's what happened to your mom. She was taken away, son. She always wanted you to be a good musician, to play the guitar. That's why I give you such a hard time, boy.
It's too hard, Daddy.
It's too hard. You're right about two things. It's too hard, and you're right about you can't, because when you say it, that's what happens. You speak it into truth. I know for a fact, the day me and your mama got in a fight, and I said, I just wish you'd die. I spoke it into truth, son. All words have power. Don't you understand?
I don't know if that's exactly true.
I've been on this earth for 45 years. You have been on this earth for 14. Soon to be a 15-year-old man. You're either going to be a musician or you're going to pull the plow out there with Dave and them.
Anything but the plow.
You better learn how to play that guitar, boy. You better learn how to play that guitar. Now, if you don't mind, it's time for Daddy to finish his mint julep and have himself a nap.
All right, Daddy.
When you're done practicing that guitar, I'd like for you to make sure that you feed the hogs, take care of them cows, wash the deck, feed them hens.
I get it, I got yours to do.
Short them scallops, hitch up the rig, pile on the pollutas, and make sure you go on down there and make it, take care of that right there now. Don't you ask no questions.
I know, Daddy, we're the only farm within 60 acres of
yes. The town of Sealville, Kentucky, to pop the pins on off for
Daddy, pain. You're drunk!
You're drunk! If the good Lord is a good man, he'll take me away! Oh, shit! My words have power! I might be dead!
Ha ha ha!
You know what I love about this place better than New York, New York?
Oh, it smells like shit. And a little bit of peaches.
That's right, Theodore.
Smells like shit.
Most importantly, the people don't look as good as I do. Not in a place like this.
Oh, that's right, Frankie. You're a New York 5, but a Kentucky 10.
Yeah. We have found ourselves the perfect place.
All right. It's good. I mean, look at this. There's just a wagon.
Right.
There's a wagon just on the side of the road. We wouldn't see that shit in New York.
No, absolutely. And if you did it, we'd spray paint it so one could at least call it culture or art.
Right.
That's what this place is missing, is culture and art.
Like theater?
Like theater, Theodore. Constantly wondering, like things like that. Things that are just like rap.
Yeah, that's what the kids are buying. And as venture capitalists, we want to sell it.
Right. Anything that all capitalists know, they know that the way to money is rap music.
Right. The kids, they don't lie.
Right.
That sweet, sweet demographic.
Yeah.
18 to 34.
A dream one day of being like Ice Cube. Or maybe even like Ice Tea.
Which is funny because you're white.
Yeah! Yeah! If he's as successful as he is, imagine how much more successful I could be being a white rapper!
Oh,
yeah. You've grown now, but we're in the state of Kentucky, where if anyone is going to be successful for rapping, it's going to be a white guy!
Wait, I'm in. Where do I sign my check?
Yes! Yes, that's it! It starts with rapping, and at some point, I get on some show like Law & Order SVU, and people start knowing my name, seeing my beautiful face on TV. That's what this place needs. More culture, more Hollywood, more New York, more big city living.
Yeah, less farms, less peaches.
Theodore, I'm like a savior to this place.
Mm-hmm. Oh. White savior.
Finally. World has waited too long for a white person to save it. And now I'm here to tell Sillville, Kentucky, I am that white person.
Yeah. You tell him, boss. I'm gonna be over here smoking a cigar.
Yeah.
Yeah. Get funky,
funky. I'm gonna get funky right now with it. Oh, here we go. A one, a two, a three, and four. Hey, look y'all still feel.
recording studio in Lexington, Kentucky.
I've seen a lot of things. I ain't seen no recording studio grow up here in Kentucky. I've seen crops. I've seen corn grow up in the fields. I ain't ever seen no studio grow up. Where do you think that studio come from? Byron, where do you think that studio come from?
The capitalist who built it?
Built it?
Yeah.
Damn, I've been sitting here thinking that some bitch just grew up out of the crops out of nowhere.
No. Someone invested money and made it happen.
You know how long I've been sitting here on the porch watching that thing just slowly build each day. I ain't never seen people around. I never saw people actually building it, so I just thought, well, all right, well, I wake up one morning and the corn is up, another morning and the pumpkins have grown, another morning, and there's a building. It must have just grown. I thought, God damn it, someone planted a seed, a building seed. The whole time, the hell you say someone built it?
Buildings don't grow out of seeds. Buildings take time, money, intent, planning. You know this.
No, I'm aware. Those are the times in which I see someone actually working on the building. This is a time that I did not. Just every time I've seen it, it just has grown a little bit more. I'm sorry. If you're here to embarrass me, that's fine. I know how to admit when I'm wrong.
Do you?
Yes, I do.
It doesn't seem like you do.
I'm not saying that a building actually grew up. I'm just saying that I thought that for a moment. I'm wrong. If you want to come after me, come after me. We want to make a big deal about it. That's fine. We can make a big deal about it. Just like you made a big deal about all the other things I was wrong about. I'm sorry. I don't have your big, fancy sixth grade education.
I know you dropped out in the fourth. Something in this town. There's a poster here. Beatbox lessons.
Huh. You feel like you need lessons for beatboxing?
Oh, I know. Someone in this town probably does.
I shudder to answer as I might be judged by what I say.
Shut up. You don't have to be so sensitive all the time. No, kid, this studio was popped up recently, but we don't know. I was just admiring it, and my friend apparently thinks buildings grow on trees.
Says him about me, but he just told you it just popped up.
Pretty sure that's just a metaphor.
Well, when I figure out what that is,
kid, you look lost.
Well, I just broke my daddy's banjo and I got kicked out.
So, you broke your daddy's banjo? In Sillville, Kentucky?
This is a whole new sound if you've never seen.
Oh, don't try to just be friends with me now just because I'm cool and know how to drop a beat. Maybe
I misjudged.
Yeah. It's like Spider-Man. Sorry, Mary Jane. You're too fucking late. I think that's the story of Spider-Man. You don't get Mary Jane at the end, right? Yeah, right. It doesn't matter if I'm right or wrong, because I can drop a sick beat. That's one of the things we learn about being gangster. Is you don't have to be right. You just gotta drop a beat. Anytime that you're wrong, and people wonder, what are you talking about right now? What rant are you rambling on? We don't understand where you're going with this. You just say, fuck it. Just like that, no one ever thinks about how stupid you are anymore. Kid, you and me, we could be a team together. You don't need those buildings.
Well, that sounds great, but I just have to speak clear that was not the story of Spider-Man.
Or was it?
Committed this building just popped up from a CD.
Yeah, it takes a lot of training here in Sealville, Kentucky.
Yeah.
Let them know where we come from. Also, you're removing hoodlums from the building that teaches rap. I feel like that's counterproductive to our demographic.
Listen, I'm a white guy, I'm learning.
Yeah, something white guys have not said in a long time. I feel like we can gain a little bit more traction if I can win this battle.
Yeah, the battle's going down tonight.
Yeah, I'm aware. I set the battle up.
I put it on Facebook. I made that sweet event.
Listen, Dad, I just want to make sure that you're going to respect me if I lose, which I won't, but if I did, will I still be part of the family trust?
Absolutely not.
What?
Those are the stipulations.
All this that we're built together?
Yeah, if you lose the battle, you're automatically demoted from your family.
I knew that there were these weird stipulations on the losers of this battle.
That's right. You're demoted from your family, you're demoted from the town, and most of all, you're demoted from having a sweet Kentucky peach.
I came to Sealville, Kentucky for one reason and one reason only, and it's for the sweet Kentucky peach. I'm ready for the battle, Pops.
You ready?
I'm ready for the battle.
All right. Well, good. Cause it's time.
Come on in, boys!
Wow, it looks so nice inside.
So this is the building that was built by a seed and seed alone. Security blanket.
have everything in you to win this band, but I'm gonna need you to do one thing. You're not just gonna rap today, babe. With my magical ghost powers, I put together your father's banjo. Where did that banjo come from? Did you have banjo seeds in your hand before? I don't know, but I think I just saw a ghost.
Let's let the battle commence.
Wait a minute! If anybody is going to watch their son play a banjo, it's going to be his motherfucking father. Go on, son. Play the way Jesus would like.
Thank you.
Charlie Day.